A day before Wisconsin's primary, life issues dominate the political debate. Jason Calvi is here with that story tonight.
Brian, if you would have watched the weekend talk shows, you would have seen the candidates facing tough questions about abortion. Donald Trump says the laws are set, while Hillary Clinton pushed her pro-abortion stance on NBC's Meet the Press.
Under Roe v. Wade, as you know, there is room for reasonable kinds of restrictions after a certain point in time.
Though Hillary Clinton hasn't said what abortion restrictions she'd support.
When or if does an unborn child have constitutional rights?
Well, under our laws currently, that is not something that exists. The unborn person doesn't have constitutional rights.
The frontrunners of both parties continue to answer hot-button abortion questions this weekend.
The laws are set now on abortion, and that's the way they're going to remain until they're changed.
Donald Trump on CBS's Face the Nation.
Meaning you'd want to change on abortion?
At this moment, the laws are set, and I think we have to leave it that way.
His spokeswoman says Trump means the laws won't change until he's president and appoints judges. All Republican candidates say they support banning most abortions after 20 weeks of pregnancy. Ohio Governor John Kasich says the target of punishment shouldn't be the mothers.
Well, look, the pro-life and the pro-choice movement have said that that's where you look at, you know, clinics or whatever, but you don't lay this on women. It's a tough enough situation for them. End of story.
In Wisconsin, Ted Cruz is up 4 points, that according to the Real Clear Politics average of polls. But Trump is predicting a really, really big win there. On the Democratic side, Bernie Sanders is ahead 2.5 points. Brian?
Jason, what have you heard in response to Hillary Clinton's comments on abortion?
Congresswoman Marsha Blackburn of Tennessee, she says that it shows no compassion for the unborn child. And she says it may signal an intention to use executive action to block these even minimal protections of the unborn.
She did use the term unborn person. That was interesting. Thank you, Jason Calvi.